All right, two tribes together to vote out one person. Victoria, anytime there's a twist involving tribal, it can be unnerving. Did you feel a different sense at Manu this afternoon?
I would say the main difference was there were no side conversations. It was one large conversation because we got even tribes here. It's four against four, so if we're not all on the same page, we're immediately screwed.
Let's talk about the Lesu tribe. Lauren, was it similar to Manu in that you all got together and said, we have to be united?
Yeah, we didn't even have to talk about staying united. We just knew that we were going to stay united. Like, we are a very strong four that genuinely has been through so much.
War Dog, it's pretty interesting. Four from one tribe, four from another, but only one going home.
It's kind of crazy because when you first said only one tribe's getting immunity, I felt that pit in my stomach, like, wow. But when we find out it was one out of eight of us preparing for the gunfight, the OK Corral, right? So I got my Wyatt Earp and my Virgil Earp, my Morgan Earp. That makes me Doc Holliday. But now we're ready to go. We got our plan. We're going to stick to each other. So it's going to be fun tonight.
But the tricky thing is they don't know us as a tribe in the same way that we don't know them as a tribe. And so it's hard to put a lot of weight into anything that's said.
Wentworth, this really is survivor warfare.
Yeah, I think this is definitely a battle tonight, but we are four strong, and we would welcome anyone over here with open arms.
Gavin, Wentworth is saying, hey, if there's anybody over there that's worried, come join us right now, and we'll change the game.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great speech, and I'd like to extend the same thing to you guys, because we're going to stick strong to our guns as well. So.
Wendy, one of the other interesting aspects is you have some insight.
Right.
Did the tribe look to you and say, what do you think?
Yeah, that's essentially what happened because, I mean, like, looking over here, I feel like I'm just having a flashback of, like, my first part of the game. So it's like I'm basically, like, in the middle of both of it.
David, that's interesting. Wendy didn't say, I used to be with them. She said, I feel like I'm in the middle.
Yeah, that's really good to hear. You know, I think it was unfortunate that the swap kicked Wendy out of this group of people, but we still consider her part of the tribe.
All of a sudden.
We love you, Wendy. We always did.
That certainly wasn't the sense when we received Wendy. When she came to us, she felt on the outs, and we welcomed her with open arms. So we're not concerned about her feeling in the middle.
So, David, you had to discuss the idea of a true deadlock tie in which you would force a rock drop.
Yeah, and you know, I'm someone who's been to rocks. I go to rocks for my people. And if it has to come to rocks tonight, then that's exactly what's going to happen. Nobody here is afraid to do that. We trust each other.
Victoria, when you hear a veteran say, oh, I will go to rocks, check my history, does that have any weight with you?
Not really. I find it really hard to believe that you would come back into this game again and again to have your fate be put into rocks if you had another option. So, like, I get it and I respect it, but I don't think you play Survivor twice, three times to go home on a rock before you even hit the merge.
Eric, you're nodding. You agree with that.
Absolutely, yeah. Survivor's fun, but it's not that fun. I don't know if I'd do it three times to go home on a rock draw.
Wendy, I'd like to talk to you for a quick second. Can we do it over here, though,
please? Sure, let's go ahead.
So is that it? You guys ready to vote?
Yep, we're ready.
All right, it is time to vote. Wentworth, you're up.
All right.
I'll go tally the votes.